Hello everybody, it's me Sam here and Torrent for WoopaGaming, and today we're going to be showing you the plugin CraftBook for Bucket by SK89Q, Me4502, The XL, Wiz Jenny, and Texas Gamer, who was a forum author, but that's all the authors on the dev bucket. So Dan, what does this plugin do?
Well, to start off, this has been heavily requested by everyone. We've received so many inboxes to do CraftBook, so we thought we'd tackle it. So CraftBook adds a number of new mechanics to Minecraft with no client mods required, so it's all server-based plugin. So anyone who downloads a vanilla client from Minecraft.net will be able to join and use the mechanics. The plugin has been around for ages. It was probably the first to add Minecraft computers, am I right?
Yeah, it was on Heyo, I believe.
Yeah, I mean, I remember it being back in alpha.
Yeah.
So, add computers, redstone ICs, so integrated circuits, moving bridges and more. And every feature of this plugin can be disabled. So if you're a server admin, you can customize anything you want within it and let players use whatever feature. So let's go.
Indeed. Okay, so this is quite a big plugin, so we're going to try and get as much of it done as possible. If there's anything we haven't covered, it will be in the wiki, which will be in the description.
Yeah, there's a very well documented wiki which will show you how to do practically everything in this plugin, but we've just covered probably things we consider most important and the most interesting.
Yeah. Okay, so the first, well, there's like three thirds. And the first one is the mechanics. So this is the first mechanic. Do you like to explain what this one does and how?
Well, it's just a bridge. Everyone's experienced that difficulty of crossing some water. So you can build a bridge by putting a sign down and having bridge in square brackets on the second line.
Yeah.
If you just right click it, everyone knows this because it's, I think it's probably one of the first things they added.
Yeah.
I mean, this has been in since alpha, like Minecraft alpha, so it's been here for ages. So if you right click the sign again on the other side, it puts it back. And you can activate this via redstone. So if I just put redstone feed over here, if you want to flick the lever, and again,
there you go. So you can make your own like drawbridge, I guess, and stuff like that.
Yeah. This is just the extreme basic design of just a small pane of water, and then.
So just to show you that.
Side. Yeah.
I just create one on the second line bridge in square brackets, and you'll notice that all the mechanics work a similar way. Like that, by putting stuff in square brackets, and it will almost always say bridge created or bridge toggled when you do stuff like that, and that will work similarly with all the other mechanisms we've got. So that's the bridge. Moving on to the next one.
Indeed. So this is better physics. Now currently, there's only support for like ladders at the moment. I don't know if they're going to plan on anything else, but this is quite cool. So if you grab some of the ladders in there,
nice step.
And if you go to the top.
I'm going to have to jump.
Are you not in creative mode?
No. Just... Right, okay. Now what?
Right, so if you go to the top of the top of this pillar I built, and if you place two ladders, one on the block you're standing and one underneath it.
Okay. In that order?
The one underneath it, yeah.
Oh, crap. Right, let's try that again.
So the one underneath it and the one top of it. There you go. And you can see the ladders will fall down.
I see.
And the animation of them falling down is actually really cool. And bear in mind, this takes no client mods. This is done all server side. Now, the purpose of this is if you're on a giant, like, if you're going mining and there's a giant hole, like a ravine, and you want to get down to the bottom safely, you can just keep placing ladders and they'll fall down to the bottom of the next available block.
Hmm.
So if you want to come down the ladder.
You want to show me? Or show the animation?
Down to the bottom. Yeah. Okay. Well, you'll see it when I break them.
Oh,
now,
okay.
They've had another feature when you can break ladders from the bottom and the top ones will fall down. So, kind of like sand. So, if I break them for you.
That's pretty cool.
It is pretty cool. So, yeah. I think that's the only thing in the better physics at the moment, but they may plan on adding more. But I think that's really cool.
Great. It's really nice.
On to the next one. This one's called Better Pistons.
Better Pistons.
So, essentially, it's just the same kind of idea is better physics, just improving what's already there.
Right.
So this is a crusher, and you create this just by putting crush
right
on the second line in square brackets. And what this will do is this will crush the existing block we got here. So we've got stone, so if I flick the switch, it'll crush it into a piece of cobblestone,
right,
as you see there. And
it'll crush it, but it'll keep the block there still.
I believe so, yeah.
I see. So. Oh no, it did change to grass.
It just gives you more cobblestone.
I see.
So, You can play around with that, put some items in, see what you get out of it. It's just, I don't know, you could probably set up a really intricate circuit with this, but we're just showing you the basics.
Yeah. It does crush it, I think. It doesn't change it. I think that's just a client update.
Okay. And this is the super sticky. It's like, you can imagine what it does. We're using a sticky piston.
With
super sticky on the second line and three with the amount of blocks we want to push. So if you flick the switch,
it was,
as you can see, in vanilla Minecraft, it would push it, but it would only retract the first one back. And the other two would stay there. So this is just adding more functionality to the pistons.
That's pretty cool.
Next one is super push. Now, I was a bit confused with this when setting it up because I forgot to read some finer parts of the wiki. But this allows you to push air.
Whoa.
So what it's doing is it's pushing five blocks as defined on the sign, and it includes air. So
I see.
If you trigger the lever, it's going to push that.
I see.
If it was sticky, I presume it would retract it.
So if I do this, that will move both of them.
Should do.
Two. Oh, I see. It's quite cool.
Good, isn't it? So I'm sure you could come up with some really cool inventions for that.
Yeah.
And finally, this is the simplest one.
Bounce.
This is the bounce one, where if you've seen our piston chest video, it's kind of similar to that. If we press the button, it will just bounce it into the air.
Whoa. And I'm guessing the third line is how high, or
yeah, that's
strength.
This is the strength of how far I push it. Now, I originally went for 10 because I thought, oh, it would be too high, but 10 literally makes it fly right up into the air, and it doesn't come down for about 30 seconds. So, yeah, be careful with that one.
That's pretty cool.
But yeah.
So that's all the piston ones.
Indeed.
Shall we move on?
Yep. This one's a gate. Very self-explanatory. We probably shouldn't go into too much depth on this, but this is another thing that was added early on. You can trigger this via redstone. It just adds for castle gates and stuff. Mm-hmm. I remember using this all the way back in beta.
Yeah.
So.
And you don't need any parameters with this?
No, just put gate on and...
So you just put the vents posts up?
Yeah.
And then anything on the floor or just...
No, I think it'll be fine with that if I just...
Right, let's do that. Yeah, okay, that's
fine. It's fine.
Alright.
So that one's really self-explanatory. There's hardly anything to it. It's just... creating on larger scales would be a bit more exciting.
See, that's quite cool.
Next thing is lifts. So to create this, create something similar to this, obviously with a object above so you can land on it when after you've clicked on the signs. So if we right click lift up, we can go up. Do you want to come do the same?
I see, yeah.
And then you can
lift down,
goes down, and you can create more floors by obviously putting signs corresponding to where you want to go.
Yeah. Oh, see.
So this is really easy. You gotta make sure you have a floor above you, obviously, before you travel up.
If it was just empty space, I guess.
And if you want to make a floor arrival only, you instead of putting up or down, you just put in the brackets just lift.
Yeah. Okay.
So if we wanted the top floor to be arrival only, and we didn't want anyone to go down, we can just put instead of putting down here. Obviously, you could just remove the sign, but you could just put lift in the square brackets.
I see. That's quite good.
Yep, so that's another one which I think everyone probably will know.
Yeah.
It's one of the very simple but very effective ones.
That's obviously
We have bookshelves. I can't remember how long this has been in for, but all you have to do is just right click the bookshelves.
And it'll give you a little message.
Indeed.
It's interesting to say the least. And you can customize them in the books.txt file as shown here. Awesome.
Right, yeah, so I think it's probably become a bit redundant with the fact that you can now make books.
Mm.
But, you know, it's always nice to have.
Yeah, got the
next
last one bit, so.
We have cooking pots.
Ooh, this is
really interesting. I really like this. So the way you have to set this up is you get a nether rack,
yeah,
and you put a sign on with the first line saying cook.
Yeah.
And unless specified, I can't remember what the exact parameter is for it to be not using fuel. But if you just write cook, then it's going to require some sort of fuel, so something like wood, saplings, or coal.
I see.
And what you want to do is you want to light the nether rack and then put a chest above it. So if you go into this chest here, you'll find there's some coal and some pork chops waiting for you.
Right.
With the pork chops, right click the cook sign, or you could just put it into the chest. It doesn't really matter which.
Oh, I see. It opens the chest for you.
Yeah. And then if you put the fuel in there.
Right. Should that start cooking then?
Should do. Have you right-clicked the fuel, the coal on the sign?
Oh, that's where we were.
That's what you need to do.
Oh, I see, like that.
There you go. So it's adding it, and then this will slowly start cooking all of the pork chops you have.
So you get loads of fuel. I see.
Have a look in the chest.
Oh, there you go. Cook pork chops. So you don't put them in the chest, you just right click the side.
Yeah, 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 and that will work. And in real time, like, it swaps them out, so it's really cool.
Yeah, that's really cool.
I know, you probably could just use a furnace, but this one looks a bit
cooler
than
just a furnace.
It's a lot
quicker as well, I just think.
Yeah.
But yeah, it loses more colour, so...
Mm.
Swings and roundabouts, swings and roundabouts.
This is one I found extremely interesting. This is the light switch and light stone. So I think what we'll go over first is the light switch.
Okay.
Now the way this works is you put, I think it's an L in square brackets on something, and when you right click it, it will change like torches into redstone torches. So if you want to give it a switch.
So right click the sign.
Yeah. You see it changes it to the redstone torches.
I see.
And it outputs a redstone signal.
Oh,
so you can turn various redstone lamps and glowstone on, and I think it's so many possibilities. You could have like street lamps, etc.
Yeah.
So if you right click again, you can
it's
see
it's effectively like a lever almost, but it has other properties.
Yeah, indeed.
I see.
So, yeah. If you go in here and grab one piece of this glowstone.
Yeah.
If you follow me. I've made a makeshift bunker down here.
Now
what the light stone is going to do is it's going to tell you the light level of anything you right click with it. So if we come out here, you right click the grass, it's going to tell you it's a light level 15 because the sun is up.
Yeah.
Naturally. So everything around here is going to be light level 15 without a doubt. Now if we go into here, you'll notice that the light level is going to start going lower because obviously there's no sunlight.
I see, you've got 8.
And if you go right to the end, it will give you a light value
5.
Of 5. Yeah.
Oh, that's quite cool.
Indeed.
So little bars and everything to show you.
So all you need to do is set the light switch up. Is literally put square brackets and an L, and then put some torches around it, and it will change. More information can be found in the wiki.
Indeed. Okay.
Next, we have an amateur. Oh. I think that's how you pronounce it, I'm not sure.
Amateur,
which is used by using coal. So if you grab some coal, and all this does is you right click it, and it will tell you the current bit of redstone you have. Bit of redstone, the level of redstone that you're clicking.
Oh, I see.
Like the level of where it is. So if I place some redstone torches down, the first circuit is a typical one where it runs out after 15 blocks. So if you click here, it should say 0. Here, it should just say 1.
Yeah, 0.
And I've just placed a repeater down, which obviously just repeats the signal. This should be 15.
So it starts to go down, and then it hits the repeater and goes.
Yeah.
I see.
So it's just easy to find out where your circuits are going wrong,
that's
I guess.
Quite cool.
Yeah, so you got that's a very simple one.
The light stone for the light, and then the coal for the...
Yeah.
Oh, that's quite good.
Moving on. We've now got... I think this is called hidden switches.
Hidden switches.
Right, so what you need to do for this is just a square brackets with an X in the middle. Put the lever down here, and obviously the redstone you want to emit.
Yeah.
So if we go around the back, what you want to do is you want to right-click the material with the switch, the signs behind. So if you turn around...
Oh, I see. It turns the switch on.
Indeed.
So you can have like a secret doorway or a secret piston thing. And that could work with potentially like the doors and the gates and stuff.
Yeah.
So that's quite good. And it works with any block? Not just the wood? Because the wood
it would work for anything. It's just in the diagram it had wood, so I decided to go for that.
Oh, I see. Fair enough. That's pretty cool.
Right, so they're all the ones I went and built. So Sam, should we go over your ones?
I guess we should. Looking wrong. Right.
So you're gonna have to explain these to me because I wasn't paying attention to these ones.
Okay, so the first one is the door. All you need for this is two signs, door up and door down.
Mm-hmm.
And then what you can do is replace the item. This time I've just chosen to use cobble, we can choose whatever you like, and just right click the sign and it will make all the blocks apart from the top line go down into the bottom block. And then you can right click again to make it to go up.
Oh, sorry, I clicked it at the same time.
Sorry.
There we go.
And then you can make it go to the top. And then this will store the blocks. You right click again, it'll put them down. But if you notice, like you just did there, if I make them go down and then I try to make them, or if I make them go, go down into the bottom block and then down again, which won't work because all the blocks are stored at the bottom, it won't work. So you have to make it sure you get the right one. But you can also use door, just door on its own, in square brackets, as opposed to door up and door down.
Oh, so it's kind of similar to the gate.
Yeah, it's kind of, they said it was like a bridge, but on its side, basically. So.
Yeah, I like that. That's a good analogy.
So that's how it's shown. Okay, so another thing is the toggleable areas. Now, this I'm going to show you first how it looks, and then I'm going to explain how to make them. So right. For this, you can right-click a sign, which I've defined, and I'll show you how to make the signs earlier. And what it'll do, it will destroy or create, or just toggle an area from one to another. So as you can see in here, it's removed the grass, turned it to air,
very nice.
And revealed these spikes. Well, that's the closest
action. Yeah.
Yeah. And then you can just right-click like that. And this is very similar to the save one as well. You can right-click and do the save area, and that will work. Sorry. A similar way to the other one. So to create this, what we need to do, let's just have a little, let's just work over here, I guess. Let's make a little orange monument. And we're going to need wood in it, so get a wood axe. And select the region. And what we're going to do, we're going to type area, save, then the area name. So just going to call it wall, for instance. And that will save the area and your name. So each player can have their own names. They don't have to share it with every other player, which is good. Okay, so now this area is saved under my player name. Now to toggle it, all I have to do is create the sign. So let's create it just next to where. First line, we have area in square brackets. And then we're going to have the area name. So we just call it wool. So we'll just type in wool there. And there we go, it said toggle area created.
Oops.
If you right click that, it will toggle
the area over.
So for this, you can make like secret doors or like secret traps like this one over here. And stuff. And again, this is obviously compatible with redstone as well. So you can just create your own redstone ones as well.
I can imagine this becoming quite handy with the bridge.
Yes, definitely.
You could create like a bridge which disappears halfway through, if you know what I mean.
And just some extra commands are area list. That'll list all the ones you got there. So the grass is the one earlier and the wall there. And area deletes, and then just name, so area delete grass. And then it will delete the schematic for the area. So that's how you can do that. Okay, so moving on, we have a trunk anchor.
Oh.
Now if you're familiar with, it's Feed the Beast, isn't it?
It's Feed the Beast Technic Pack has it in it as well.
Oh, it has it in there. Okay.
I think Feed the Beast does, I'm not sure.
Okay, this will basically just keep the trunk open, so if you've got like mine carts and stuff, they'll be spawned. And this again is toggleable with redstone on and off. And it's usually just put trunk on the second line with square brackets. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So this one, there's also some mechanical drops. The first one is apples can be dropped with leaves, but now that can be in default Minecraft anyway. It's not that useful. But one thing that is still useful, I guess, is the ability to drop books when you destroy bookcases.
They do that anyway.
Do they?
Yeah.
I thought they just destroyed.
No, you do get books.
Ah, well, that's one of the mechanics. That was there, and now we're just going to quickly move on. And there is okay, anyway. So there's also teleporters. So for this, you just put square brackets teleporter, and then the location you want to be teleported to.
So the X and Y coordinates.
So yeah, X, Y, and Z. So we've gone 4.5, 4, and then minus 6.5. You can put decimals in there and whatnot. And you see that end stone, that's that location there. So
I did wonder why that was there when we were doing it.
Well, if I right click there, I get teleported to that location.
Very nice.
I have to keep remembering the number to type in. It's a bit annoying, but there you go. Okay.
Cool, that's good.
Also, custom crafting. So you can add your own crafting recipes and furnace recipes to the config. I'll go over the config and how to add recipes later. But for instance, we can make end stone by placing two wall on the bottom and do birch stone, and we get an end stone block. So you can create your own crafting recipes just like that, and basically your players will be able to make them and whatnot. Okay.
Wow. Did you just make end stone? That's great.
Yeah, just from.
I just realised that.
Yeah, so you can create your own crafting recipes.
Awesome.
And various recipes and stuff. Okay, so now we have the chair. This is, if you're familiar with a chair's plugin, it's basically the same thing. It does require a protocol lib if you want to use this feature though. Thank you very much. To do this, to sit on the chair, just simply paste any block which is in the config. Most of them are just half steps because they look the most like stairs. Just shift click and right click the stair, and you can see yourself sitting down on the chair. And to get off, you just simply walk, or you can just jump off or whatnot. So let's just get that back. You can add more blocks to it if you want. You could add like a wall block or a half step and stuff, and you can just sit on those. But it makes sense to have half steps because they're, well, they most look like the stair most.
Indeed.
Okay, we will also have command signs. To make this, you simply just have command and then that's command underneath on the third and fourth lines. And to use it, you simply right click and it will set the time to day.
So these have probably been made obsolete by command blocks that have been introduced into Minecraft recently.
Yes.
But if the server doesn't allow command blocks and has CraftBook on it, I suppose this is a good alternative.
Yep. So you can set the time, set day. And you can also have it for the player on it. So let's make a new one. So for instance, we have say hello and then at P. And what that'll do, when I right click, it'll say my name. So hello player and hello extra and stuff. So that's just one of the ways it can be used. Okay, there's also one which is a map changer. So if we grab a map.
Well, oh, right. I thought it was actually going to change like the server map or something.
Oh, no, no, no. So let's just create this map. Blah, 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 blah. That is. How do we see the idea of this map? Map 4. Okay, so I've got map 4. But I can actually change the idea of this map to say map 1 by right clicking this sign. And there we go. I've got map on there.
So, oh, that's awesome.
Unfortunately, they are all the same.
No longer trading maps with people now.
Yeah. So you can just choose any other ID. So there we go, map 2 and whatnot. And just simply right click on the map. Unfortunately, these all maps are all the same, so it doesn't actually matter. But obviously, if they were, it wouldn't. Okay, so this last one in the mechanics, let's just get rid of this, so mind me, is the XP store. That's the one. Unfortunately, I don't have any XP. Let's give myself some XP. Oh, right. So what I need to do is just simply right-click the mob spawner, and what it will do is it will convert all the XP I had into bottles of enchanting, and then I can store up my XP that
That's
way.
Nice.
And whatnot. Now you notice I did have level 11, and now I've just got the XP and then spent it all. I've only got XP level 4 now. That's because it will make it less than what you had originally. That is set in the config as well. So it's a good way of saying storing up loads of EXP
awesome.
And stuff.
Yeah.
Because, well.
Oh, well, I could think of a use for this. On, say, like on PvP servers, if this was enabled and you wanted to go out and fight, but you don't want to lose all your levels,
yeah.
You could. Get all the potions, store it at your base safely, and then go and have a PvP.
You could do, and you wouldn't lose your XP then. And you could potentially just build up tons and tons.
Yeah, that's really
so
cool.
You could use it.
Nice. Right, so I suppose once we finish the mechanisms, do you want to go quickly cover like the transport vehicles?
Yeah, I guess we could.
So if you do walk cart, I prepared this earlier.
Right, very nice.
Now,
very nice.
This isn't going to take too long to explain because it's pretty similar.
Okay.
Now, there's a lot of stuff in the vehicles, but we've only decided to touch the surface because it's better if you go and have a look yourself. But I have set a few things up here. So the first thing you should realise is this one here, is the cart is continuously going forward without any booster tracks.
Whoa.
So obviously, this is going to be similar to, you must remember Minecart Mania from Aphorus back in
definitely.
The day. It's kind of similar to that. So what we've got going on here is we've got a cart continuously going round, and the gold ore serves as a booster. It serves as a booster. So the lever turns it on, so it's controlled by redstone.
So if we turn off these ones, it should slow down?
It should eventually slow down, yeah,
there
until
we
turn them back on. If you want to turn this one back on so it doesn't slow down over here.
There we go.
Right, so yeah, they're the boosters. And with most minecart things like this, where you have blocks which control a minecart, you also get brakes. Now, the most obvious brake to use would be soul sand, which I've got set up here. So if we turn this on, control by redstone again, you can see it gets slowed down by 50%, and then it shoots off again. You can slow it down by 20% by using gravel, but soul sand's just the easiest. Oh, I've gone into the car again.
You keep doing that.
I know.
Turn this one off.
Yeah, yeah. So we've got one more block to cover, so it's going to keep going. And this wall, this white wall, cloth, depending on what you call it, counts as a reverser. So if you want to give it a flick, you see it will reverse the direction of whatever way it's going.
It's funny, so it looks like it's on a
It looks like it's going normally, but yeah, there you go.
It's a good reverse index. That's quite cool, it's like a bumper almost.
So that will come in handy later, but we'll cover the uses of what that will do when we get round to it. So you turn over here.
Okay.
What we've got going on here is an ejector block. At the moment it's turned off, so if you want to get in the minecart, as you see, Sam will just be having a nice little ride.
Yep.
If I flick the switch on after he goes over, when you place an iron block under some rails, it can eject a player out. So this can be handy when it comes to stations, etc. Whenever you want to eject a player, really.
Does it eject mobs as well? Or?
I would presume so, but I haven't given it a go. I'd never have much luck getting mobs into minecarts.
It seems to get on all the time. Right.
So yeah, that's the simple one. All you need to do is, for this to work, you need to have a sign under saying eject, if you want to just showcase that.
Yeah, just that.
And obviously it can be controlled via redstone.
Awesome.
Right, next one. This is a station one. This is the one I think is pretty cool. Again, you'll need a sign under here, just with the first line saying station.
Right, yeah.
And the block which corresponds to this is some obsidian. So if you want to get in the minecart, again, I'll give you a little push. That block will boost you around. So what this is going to do is this will stop you at the defined bit of obsidian. So this is useful, obviously, it's a station block. So when you want to build a massive station, you want people to stop at controlled points instead of using like the brakes. If I stop you there, you come to a direct start.
I see.
And if I hit you again, the minecart will start going. So it's useful for stations, really. Getting in these minecarts. There we go.
Awesome.
So yeah, that was pretty simple. All you need is the sign of a station.
That's pretty good.
On the second line. And as I said earlier, we're coming over to this one. You can see this.
This is really funny. I'm sorry.
This is really good. You know, I said the cloth would come in handy later. This isn't necessary. You could have it going round in a big circle, but I decided to be
efficient.
Well, efficient by putting it here. Now, what this is the deposit and collect. Functions with the iron ore. So you put the iron ore underneath the rails where you want it to either deposit something or collect it. If we just break this, you can see there's a slight, actually no, you have to come around this side because I put it around here. And I can't remember which one that says.
Deposit.
Right, now that will deposit all the contents from the chest into the minecart chest. And this one here, I just broke it, lovely.
Good one. I guess
no, you can write it down if you want.
Collect.
On the second line, just put in the square brackets, connect, underneath, yeah, like that.
Done.
Right, so if you want to chuck a load of items into this chest, if you like proper fill it up with just a load of rubbish you have on you, you see when the minecart comes back, well that was quite quick actually, the items would have gone, and it's gone all into this chest, so if you take them back again.
Alright, let's try.
And, if I stop this minecart. Right, there we go.
Right, so if I. Oh.
Right, I've just destroyed it. Okay. So. If I push him along again, you check that cart. Check the cart.
Oh, now. It's got full of stuff.
It's got all the stuff in it.
I see, so it fills the chest up. So it doesn't do it one item at a time, it doesn't the whole thing at the time.
Yeah.
I'm guessing. There we go.
So we push it back, and there you go, it puts it in this chest. So that could come in handy in, well, I think probably one of the main uses is like shops or something. You have like a collection bin where people put their stuff in, and it comes into your bit, and then you can pay them money or vice versa.
I see. Makes sense.
So there's a load of other features with the minecarts, but I think these are the most important ones when it comes to it. The possibilities you could do with this are endless, I guess.
I mean, this one here, you could just have one going back and forth, just collecting all your ores and stuff.
Oh, yeah. Oh. I didn't even think of that. That's amazing, Sam. When you go mining, yeah, that's great. You can have a little drop box at your base underground, which you can take it to your main base. Oh, Sam, that's fantastic.
Just saves walking, you know.
And then I think we'll come to that point later with what we cover in the next video.
Yes, indeed.
Which will be the ICs, I think.
It's quite a lot of ICs, so we're going to save that for the next video.
Yep.
So thanks for watching. It's been me, Sam, here in Toronto, WoopaGaming, signing out.
We'll see you in the next video, bye. Part 2.
Bye.
See ya. Head. So in this case, it'll be zombies and skeletons. You can change your zombies to have a Hero Brian face if you want. But you can have monsters spawn with random playheads.